Hi everyone, my name's Tim Ogden. I'm the Dean of the College of Business at Manchester University. And joining me are Brandy Chauncey, Manchester's Director of Admissions, and Joe Messer, the Mark E. Johnston Professor of Entrepreneurship. We're visiting today with Brady Pyra, an accounting major who's finishing his junior year this month. Brady expects to earn both the bachelor's and master's degrees at the end of next year, and he's also a member of The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. Welcome, Brady.
Thank you.
Brandy, will you get us started, please?
Hi, Brady. I just would like us to start with just hearing a bit about how you ended up at Manchester.
My dad's a professor here, so I knew about Manchester growing up my entire life. However, I served my mission out in Idaho. Part of it was BYU Idaho. That was part of my mission. So I originally wanted to go there first. However, I was late starting it and I didn't get my form submitted on time. Manchester was kind of a second place spot. My original plan was to only come here for a year, transfer my credits and go there. But I came here and I really, really enjoyed it. I love the professors here. And so then I just stayed and I'm really glad that I did.
So when you first came to Manchester, were you planning on being an accounting major?
Yes. So the story about that is my dad obviously played a hand in it. At the high school here in Manchester, my senior year, they just started to offer an accounting class. And so my dad marked me for that, and I really enjoyed that class. And so ever since then, I knew that I really wanted to be an accountant.
Brady, did you have any worries or misgivings about coming to a school that wasn't affiliated with your church?
No, not really.
And you had to take a religion class as part of your liberal arts requirements. What was that like?
I really enjoyed that class. So it was with Justin Lasser. And it was the Intro to Hebrew Bible class. And I greatly, greatly enjoyed it. He taught very clearly, very simply. Some of the things were kind of complex, but he made it easy to understand. Basically everything he taught like went pretty much right along with at least most, if not all of our teachings.
Brady, I'm going to move away from talking about academics and talk about your work experience. I've known you for a while. You were in yard maintenance, you were a chicken farmer, you were doing sales one summer, and now you're working in an orthopedics company in the accounting department. I'd like to talk to you about your sales experience and how your mission interacted with your sales experience. Do you think it helped you in sales?
I think it did, yes. So obviously on my mission, I have to go around introducing myself to new people every day. And that's, especially for me, before my mission, I was a very introverted person. And so my mission helped break me out of that shell a little bit, build my confidence a little bit more. When I decided to do summer sales, those skills that I developed filtered right into it. Even though like money-wise, it wasn't very successful, doing summer sales helped me continue to break out of my shell and build up my confidence even more.
Can you just tell us more about your mission? It sounds like it was a pretty broad and good experience for you. So could you just tell us a little bit about that?
Yeah. So, I mean, the schedule was, when I was on my mission, the schedule was pretty regimented. So like we'd wake up at 6 o'clock every morning. We'd exercise, get dressed, shower, eat breakfast, stuff like that. And then we would start our morning studies at 8 o'clock. So we'd start with a personal study from 8 to 9 and then a companionship study from 9 to 10. And for those learning language, in which I went Spanish speaking, we got an hour of language study as well. Then from there, we'd have lunch and then we'd go out and we would go out and meet people, whether members or non-members, people who we were already teaching. It was a time of self-building, because it strengthened my faith in Jesus Christ as I went and taught others. Because I had to know him first. I had to know him better first myself. And so from learning him myself, I was able to go out and teach others about him as well. As part of the mission, you go to what's called a missionary training center. We call it the MTC for short. The church had recently opened a Mexico MTC, and so I went there for 6 weeks. And then from there, then I went to my mission in Idaho. So it was a lot of playing time.
We talk about some car time here at Manchester. you live close by. You live 30 minutes away or so. Would you describe Manchester as a welcoming community? Does it fit with your personality and values?
Oh, yes. Yeah, I definitely think so. People here are very, very accepting. I mean, obviously, like professors and students, they have their point of views, but they're also very accepting of other people's views and thoughts as well.
Also, as an LDS member, do you find that fitting with Manchester's values?
Yes, very much so.
Can you tell us about your internship at Zimmer Biomet?
So I originally applied about in September of 2017. I just kind of thought, you know, I may be just a freshman, but I may as well go ahead and give it a shot. Because what's the worst that could happen? They don't look at my resume. All right, no harm, no foul. I got an email one day. Hey, we'd like to bring you into an interview. When do you have available? My interview went really well, and I've had the job since my first semester as a freshman, and I really, really enjoy it. It's developed a lot of skills like leadership, organization, prioritization. It's also helped me build like some of the technology skills as well, particularly like Excel and Access. And obviously Manchester's training helped me with those skills as well.
Did any of your mission experiences transfer to that internship experience?
Yes. So as part of your mission, you have to be at least relatively organized, in particular, like when you're traveling places, organization and persistence. I've been able to transfer those skills to my internship.
How about your relationship with faculty at Manchester? Can you tell us a little bit about your relationships in and out of the classroom?
Yeah. So the faculty here are very, very open and welcoming, particularly now during this time. In fact, two of my professors that I meet with, like still during regular class time, they finish their meeting saying that like to reach out to them if they need anything, whether it's related to class or not. They're very welcoming and very willing to help you, not just with class and school, but also like in your everyday life as well. And I actually reached out to one of those professors because I just really needed to talk somewhat to someone because I'm cooped up inside all day because I work from home now. And so I texted the professor and said, hey, can I call you later tonight? And yeah, we talked for about half an hour and it was really, really good.
Brady, you and my son, Ross, were high school classmates. You were also teammates on the soccer team. I won't mention what your nickname was there. Ross went to college in Utah, and I know how difficult that was for me and for his mother in the 4 years that he was in Utah, how difficult it was to getting back and forth and when he had medical issues, the hassles there. Are there any advantages of going to school close to home? And if so, what would those be?
I mean, obviously one advantage is like travel time. Being close to home, I can commute to school. And like you said earlier, it's about half an hour, so it's not a bad commute. Also in the long run, that saves a lot of money too, living off campus and with my own family. So I don't have to pay any resident costs as well. But I also like it just because the area is familiar. I know where places are. So if we want to go someplace or like go for a walk as a family, then we can. I don't have to try and look someplace up and then look directions. I know exactly where to go. And so it's just all very familiar for me.
So also as someone who's raising a beautiful young family, you found this area to be acceptable to live in then?
Yeah, very much so.
Brady, if you were speaking to a prospective student from the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, what would you say some of the positives are about considering Manchester and what might some of the challenges be that a student might face?
One of the positives, and also for me, one of the things that made me reconsider Manchester is like to stay here is class sizes. This, I guess, kind of goes back to the faculty, is because you're, it feels very one-on-one during, even during class time. The professors are right there and you can ask them questions. They're very open to questions. The classes, they are very difficult, but at the same time, they're preparing us for our careers. So I would consider the curriculum in general as a very big positive to help prepare us for our careers. And a lot of professors do that. I know, especially with Professor Messer and Professor Lutz, we have to develop our own product and marketing strategy. And for the accounting side, we have to completely develop our own, basically, software, accounting software. As far as any challenges, none really come to mind.
Is there anything else that you want to share that we haven't asked you about?
I'm just really glad that I came to Manchester because, like I said earlier, it wasn't my first choice, but I stayed and I'm really, really glad I did. And one of the really big positives is that is because I can get my master's in accounting, not just my bachelor's, but I can get my master's in accounting in 4 years, which I think, again, is a really, really big positive.
Well, thanks so much, Brady.
Thank you all.
Thanks, Brady.